You mentioned the relationship between the United States and Western Europe and indirectly Eastern Europe. How about the emergence of Asia? How is that linked into the prosperity ultimately of the Eastern Europe?
Yeah, it's very interesting because of course you would think for many of the countries there is a strong proximity of China. China is of course very close with borders to Russia, but it's close to parts of Russia that are less developed and where they're rich in natural resources. Things that Chinese would be interested in, and of course a need for consumer products in Russia and so on. But the trading links are very much underdeveloped compared to potential, I think. So I think over time we will probably see more of that development. We see also now a lot of Chinese investment, particularly in Central Asia, but also in other parts of the region. We see it in Ukraine, in Central Europe now. So the Chinese are becoming more part of this. But if you look over a longer period of time and look at what has been achieved in terms of exports, the region has done very well and been able to compete actually with China in most important markets. So very strong export growth, very strong general growth, and then also in particular sectors that the region is dependent on. It has been very successful. So the problem with that is, of course, that this was relying on a number of factors that are not necessarily there in the future. It was low labor costs. There was a lot of potential for trade improvements, new trade arrangements, also strong growth in major export markets. All those factors are much weaker now. So it will be a challenge to compete with the emerging Asia, but also a lot of opportunities, I think, for the region.